Welcome, this is How to HubSpot. I'm Thomas. Last week, I was dabbling around in HubSpot's free landing page builder, and I found some pretty cool stuff that I'm excited to teach you today. You'll learn how to create visually appealing pages, how to maximize them for your impact, and top tips for optimization. So whether you're just getting started in marketing or you're a seasoned veteran, I think that you're gonna find this super helpful because we're gonna teach you how to transform your landing pages into lead generating machines. Before I forget, we're gonna be using HubSpot's free landing page builder. We provided a link in the description below. Make sure to check it out. Follow along. For this example, let's say I own a coffee company. We're gonna call it Tommy's Coffee Original. I want to create a landing page for Tommy's Coffee's grand opening. Before we get started creating our landing page, we need to know when to use it. Let's define our why, who, and what. Why am I creating this landing page? Well, I want folks to sign up for my grand opening so they can, one, claim the free coffee that I'm offering, and two, I can add them to my email list. Next, who is my landing page targeting? I'm targeting local coffee lovers, because who doesn't love coffee, and previous customers. And lastly, what steps do the visitors on my landing page need to take to achieve my goal? Three things: first name, last name, and email. It's very important to understand that you want a low barrier of entry for them, as this will deter them from making a decision quick if it's too much information. Now that you've answered those three questions, it's time to build your landing page. Let's do it. So to start, we're gonna go on over to Content, Landing Pages. Then on the top right-hand corner, Create Landing Page. We're gonna name this Tommy's Coffee's Grand Opening. Create, and then we're gonna choose from a selection of templates, and because we are in fact creating a landing page, you guessed it, we're selecting landing page. Select that template, and then we are ready to edit. So first things I like to do personally is I wanna just delete all these modules because we're not gonna need these even though they look fantastic. It's just gonna kinda messy up the page, so go ahead and delete that. There are five tools for success when creating a landing page. Number one is headline. You wanna make sure that your headline states the type of offer that you're offering so that search engines can also understand it. Here, we're gonna delete popular item because we don't need that. And the headline of our page is going to be called Register for Tommy's Coffee's Grand Opening. This is a little small. We want to increase the text here so we can go to size. I think 36 is probably going to be, yes, I like that. I like that a lot. We'll make this center and we will add a space and that looks good. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color here to white. I know it sounds crazy. You're probably like, Thomas, what are you doing? It's going to look good. We're going to add a background image. So this will all make sense in a second. We'll click on the top section and we will select background image. And I've already pre-uploaded all these images before this demo, so you can go ahead and do that yourself if you'd like and save some time. And then we will browse images. All right, this is looking great. Next is copy. This is text that conveys your message, your value proposition, and your call to action. No one wants to read an endless novel when they're trying to make a fast decision. So it's good to keep it short and sweet. Focus on the main points, preemptively respond to objections, and build your trust with your prospects. So to do that, we're gonna go back to sections and we're gonna add the about section right below our header. This is where we're gonna incorporate our body copy as well as our CTA. So we won't need this about the company, we can delete that. And where it says coffee is best online, we can change that to the copy that we would like, which is join us for an exclusive event and claim your complimentary pack of coffee beans. Let's put that in there. Again, that's too small. I want to make this a little bigger. So that is not enough. We'll do, okay, there we go. Cool. And I want a little bit of space between that and the headers, and that looks great. All right, so now what we'll do is we want to add the body. The body is going to be, like I mentioned, focus on the main points. You want to make it very clear what you're offering, what the customer is going to be getting when they go to this event. Next are images. Always include at least one image, video, or animation on your landing page. That gives the visitors a much needed tangible idea of what they're going to receive. And most importantly, a visual can tell a complex story much quicker than words can, but make sure that it supplements and doesn't distract from the conversion experience. So with that being said, let's add some images to this landing page. We are going to go to modules and you scroll down, you will see image. Let's slide this right next to our body paragraph. And we are going to replace that with, let's see here. I like this picture. This is nice. Look at this coffee. Oh, it looks so good. I need coffee. I need coffee immediately. Next is forms. This is an element where visitors will submit info in exchange for an offer. This converts that visitor into a lead. Music to my ears. We love leads. Remember, the primary goal of your landing page is to convert visitors into leads. So it's crucial to make sure that the form is the focal point of your page. All right. To add a form to this landing page, we go to Modules, Form. We're going to slide it right below our image and body paragraph. I've already pre-made a form, so we just have to select it from this list. Tommy's Coffee Grand Opening. Wonderful. Look at that. The button is already on brand, looking great, looking fabulous. The only thing we need to do is change a couple of minor things here. For one, I want to change the fields to match the color of brown. So we'll change that. That looks great. First, last name, and email look fantastic. And this button is kind of awkwardly on the left-hand side of the page. We don't want that. That's not nice. We want it to be right in the middle. And finally, number five, the CTA, or call to action, is the button that we want visitors to click to claim their free coffee. Just like the landing page copy, the CTA copy also needs to be action-driven. You want to make sure that the visitors know what they're getting when they click this button. In our case, they're going to be clicking get your coffee, and that's going to sign them up for the event, and they can claim their coffee. What's a landing page without landing? You know, then it's just called the flying page. Yes, you want your landing page to stick the landing. So how do you do that? Optimization. The tricky part is knowing what to optimize. You've got images, you've got videos, you've got animation, you've got UI. There's so much to figure out, but which one are you actually trying to target? All of them. Every single one. Luckily, by using the five tools of success, we've already ingrained the best practices for optimization in our landing page. We've used a compelling offer, which is free coffee. We've used great images, and also we have a clear path to conversion. Our form is the focal point of our landing page. So what else can you do if you're not tired of optimizing yet? Check out our optimization tools. It's in the left-hand column here by the speedometer. If you click on that, there's a ton of recommendations there to amp up your page and make sure that you are in fact optimized. Landing pages have an endless horizon of possibilities to capture new leads, and they demand your attention. As long as you follow those five tools for success, you're on your way to creating high converting landing pages. Well, that's it for me today. I'm Thomas. If you're looking to level up your business, make sure to subscribe and check out our channel to see when the next video drops. And drop a comment if there's a feature you're excited to learn about. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one.